What are you guys?
Well, we've been called ghost hunters, paranormal researchers.
But we prefer to be known simply as Ed and Lorraine Warren.
My name is Lorraine Warren, and I'm a psychic. And my husband was sensitive, you know. He wasn't as psychic I was, but he was sensitive. And we have investigated thousands of cases throughout the world. We've had some bad experiences. I mean, really bad experiences.
Devil's hour, 307, 315, things commonly happen. And the question is why?
Unfortunately, that is usually always right on when there's a serious haunting.
You know, people waking up startled at 3 o'clock for no reason.
Poltergeist playing frisbee with your grandma's fine china, throwing you across the room.
3 incidences, 3 whispers, somebody calling your name 3 times, or 3 knocking sounds.
All night long, just like that.
Does it come in threes?
Yeah.
Stops at dawn?
Uh-huh.
Anything that comes in threes would be a mockery to Christianity.
Sometimes it's meant as an insult to the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
It's the psychic hour of the night.
It's usually around 3 a.m. where people are most sensitive to spirit activity or any type of paranormal activity. The veil between the spirit world and our world is lifted in a way.
The problem arises when you deal with the entities who are not so nice, because everything is out there and they're not all our friends.
You have a lot of spirits in here, but there's one that I'm most worried about because it is so hateful.
And they are stronger.
Some of these things, you can't get rid of them.
Look what she made me do.
You just have to learn how to deal with it.
Tragedy creates the ghost syndrome. The spirits remain earthbound. They don't know how to accept their death. They're looking for help, but sometimes they don't accept the help.
You're all gonna die.
It's standing right behind you.
It's such a negative energy, and it takes a lot of energy to work with the darker spirits because they're so resistant to any type of smooth transition to another side.
When a murder has occurred, or when a suicide or something terrible has occurred, there are repercussions that echo across the multiverse and can come out when the world boundaries are thinner. And people attributed most of this to the devil, particularly around 3 o'clock in the morning, the devil's hour.
Faith is a powerful thing. The belief in such a time, the devil's hour, could be fueling its power. If you go in thinking something spooky is gonna happen, something spooky will probably happen.
The devil wants to remind us he's there, that he's around. When you wake up at 3 o'clock, you never know what you're gonna see at the edge of your bed.
Is it because it's the darkest just before the dawn? I just know what I can do to protect myself, and I have my faith. And if there's some way, through my knowledge, that I can help people,